Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to reset Windows 11 without affecting your data. If your Windows 11 operating system device is not working as expected, then you can reset it. And when you make a Windows 11 reset without affecting your data, it will do following things. This process will reinstall Windows 11 and keeps your accounts and personal files, removes apps and drivers you installed, removes changes you made to settings, and this will also remove any app your PC manufacturer or device manufacturer has installed. In case if your device came with Windows 11 pre-installed, apps from your device manufacturer will be reinstalled by this process. In order to show that your data will not be affected, I have placed demo file and demo folder on this desktop. This will help you to understand that no data is affected after this reset process. So make sure you spot these two items after the reset process has been carried out. Now let's start the resetting process. So right click on the start button and select settings. When the settings app opens, go to system and scroll down in that window. Locate the recovery section. Inside recovery section, under recovery options, you will find reset this PC. Click on the reset PC button there. Now under choose an option, you have two options: keep my files, and another option is remove everything. If you select keep my files, you will be able to reset Windows 11 without affecting your data. Now in the next screen, select how you want to reinstall Windows. Here you have two options. The first option is cloud download and second option is local reinstall. The first option requires that you are connected to the internet while the reset process has been carried out. While if you select local reinstall, you can reinstall Windows 11 directly from your device and there is no internet connectivity required. So in this example, I am selecting local reinstall. You will click on the next button. Then we have here, this PC was recently updated. If you continue with reset this PC, you won't be able to undo the update. That means the latest update we have installed on the device will remain as it is. So currently this system is on build 25158, and after the reset I will be able to maintain this Windows Insider build update. Now click on the next button to proceed. So now our system is ready to reset, and here we can see that resetting will change settings back to their default, keep personal files, reinstall Windows from this device and remove all apps and programs. In case if you want to see the list of apps removed, you can click on view apps that will be removed link here, and here I can see the list of apps that will be removed. You can take a screenshot of this screen so that you can reinstall these apps after the reset process has been carried out. Now we will click on the back on this screen, and here we have a note, this will take a while and your PC will restart. Click on the reset button here. So the resetting process has now started, and here you can see that it is now preparing to reset. This preparing screen will take some time, and after that you will find that the system is about to restart and Windows 11 will automatically restart. Then after the restart you will see please wait on the boot screen. This will take a while again. Then here we have resetting this PC screen. This screen will take time depending upon your system. So make sure your system is plugged in during this reset process. And here you can see that the resetting this PC has some percentage, and it will go from 1% to 100%. So let this be working. So after a while it has been reached to 99%, and now it is about to finish. So we will be finishing this screen, and then the system is restarted again. So the reset process has been now carried out. Now after this restart, Windows will be installing again. That is basically a reinstall, And again, this screen will go from 1% to 100%. So make sure your system remains on and plugged in. And as you can read out in the screen, your system may restart a few times. So it has been reached to 18% as of now, and then system restarted again. After the restart, we can see here welcome on the boot screen, and after that again it moved to installing screen, which is now at 64%. After a while it has reached to 98%, and then our system is now back to the lock screen. So we can now pull up the lock screen, and here if you noticed, the screen size has moved to default settings. That means the display setting we have customized earlier is now reset, and we can now pull up this lock screen, and here we have ability to log in. So we can now type in our PIN, password or whatever sign in option you are using. Since this was reset without affecting data, that means our account has been preserved here and we do not need to create account after this reset process. Only the settings we have customized on this system has now reset. After signing process has been completed, we are now getting the first time sign in animation screen. This might take a while. I have speeded up this section in order to make this video compact. So after reset process has been carried out, our system is now back to desktop, and here you can see that the demo file and demo folder are already preserved. That means the data is not affected by this reset process. Also, we have a list of removed apps on this screen, and there is also a Microsoft Edge shortcut that comes after the reinstall process. And here it is not being shown because I have removed Microsoft Edge earlier on this system. While all the apps you can see are now pre-installed here. So in this way we have finally carried out reset of Windows 11 without affecting our data. If you have any question about this process, do let me know via your comments. I will be happy to help you. So that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.